Welcome, welcome to a fun and exciting area called Statement of Cash Flows. Cash flows, very heavily tested, very important area. We're going to probably spend an hour, hour and a half on this right now in different sections or different little video clips, but it's going to be a really important area. You need to understand this, heavily tested on the exam, very important for real world, right? You're out there doing a job. This is stuff we're going to cover both for GAAP and then at the very end of the section under IFRS and how the comparisons and differences. All right, statement of cash flows. So we've got our statements. Whose statements are these? Management's, right? Management is responsible for the preparation for the content and so on. A complete set of financial statements is a balance sheet, income statement, statement of changes in stockholders' equity, statement of cash flows, other comprehensive income, things like that. So a statement of cash flows is just this. It talks about how much cash did I have at the beginning of the year, burning a hole in my pocket? How much cash do I have at the end of the year? We're looking at the difference between the beginning and the end, and we're trying to see what are the changes in cash. So what it tells me is how much cash do I have at the beginning, how much do I have at the end, and the difference is the increase or decrease in cash. So let's say, for example, at the beginning of the year I had $100, at the end of the year I have $250. That means I've got $150 more cash burning a hole in my pocket. My jobs to figure out where did this cash come from. So as we look at this, we're going to see that the cash could come from either operating activities or investing activities or financing activities. And you're going to see this plus or minus this equals the net change. So what we're trying to do is to see, hey, I got $150 more money in my pocket. Where did it come from? Where did that money come from? That's the purpose of the statement of cash flows. So what we're going to have to do is understand, first of all, what is the definition of cash? But also, because we're talking about the change in cash, the other thing is we need to define what these activities are. The FASB very carefully defined investing and financing. If it's not investing or financing, what is it? Boom, operating. So operating is like the catch-all. You don't know where to put it in operating. So that's what we're looking at as far as where the amounts are coming from. So we've got operating, investing, and financing. FASB carefully defines investing, financing. Everything else is what? Operating. All right. So again, the key is the change. Changes and face this train. Who sang that song many years ago? David Bowie. Changes. There you go. All right. Look in your notes. It says statement of cash flows is required whenever a company presents the results of operations. So you provide an income statement, you've got to have a statement of cash flows. The purpose is to provide inflows and outflows, sources and uses. What is the source of money coming in? What is the use of money going out? Where did the money come from? Where is the money going to? That's our sources and uses. Now, we talk about cash, right? What is cash? We know what cash is. That's the green stuff you carry around, makes you popular, gets you friends, gets you dates, right? You can buy a date. What is a cash equivalent? Because it's cash and cash equivalents. That's the first balance on the balance sheet. Cash equivalent is a highly liquid investment with an original, keyword is original maturity of 3 months or less. So, highly liquid, original maturity of 3 months or less. So if you look in your notes, it says easily convertible into known amounts of cash, so it's highly liquid, and original maturity of 3 months or less from the date of purchase. So what that means, for example, is original maturity to you, the purchaser. For example, I have a one-year CD, a one-year bank certificate of deposit, and I've had it for it's a one-year CD and I've had it for 9 months, 8 months, all right? What is the original to me? 1 year, it's still an investment. Example two, you have a one-year CD that matures in a week. I buy it from you. What is the original maturity to me? A week, so it's like debit cash, credit cash. So on the balance sheet, it's kind of a wash, right? It's like debit cash equivalent, credit cash, but where does it show up on the balance sheet? Cash and cash equivalents, it's the same line item. So again, if the original maturity of me is 3 months or less, cash, cash. If it's longer than 3 months, investment cash. So it goes into the investing, which would be an investing activity. Okay? So that's the first thing you need to understand as far as what shows up there on the statement of cash flows. Now, as I said earlier, there's three different categories. What are they? Operating, investing, and financing. And the reason I like to cover this later in the course is because of the fact that all of this deals with journal entries that we had to learn. Now we've finally gone through journal entries like making a sale, journal entries like equity method, cost method. We've talked about all these different areas, deferred taxes, that before we hadn't talked about. Now that we've covered them, now we can go through and actually look at a statement of cash flows and have it make some sense, because there's so many entries on there, we've got to figure out how each of these journal entries affects cash and cash equivalents.